Hey guys, it's Dani. Welcome to another Orchid Care Tips for Beginners episode. Today we are going to talk about miniature Phalaenopsis orchids, which in recent years have increased a lot in popularity because they look just as beautiful as your normal or standard Phalaenopsis, but they're much tinier, so they fit better on desks or on shelves, on your windowsill. And in the space where you could keep a normal or big Phalaenopsis orchid, you can keep 4 miniature Phalaenopsis. So because I do get comments a lot asking me if they're different than the normal Phalaenopsis, if they require different care, I decided to make a video in which we talk only about these guys and how they compare to normal Phalaenopsis. Today's episode, along with our entire Orchid Care for Beginners series, is sponsored by repotme.com, who offers you everything you could possibly need to properly take care of your orchid, from media to fertilizer, pots, and all sorts of accessories. Some of the accessories that I will use in this care series and in today's video are provided by repotme, so I will link you to their website down below in the description. Feel free to visit them at any time. So that said, let's bring in a normal Phalaenopsis and see what the differences are. So here we have a normal standard Phalaenopsis. You can see that she's leaning quite a lot, which is very normal for any type of Phalaenopsis. And she's so heavy due to the weight of the leaves and also the flowers that I really need to keep her in this decorative container, which is quite heavy. And inside we have the typical orchid pot, which is transparent, has slits for ventilation, and the orchid is very happy in it. So in comparison, here is a miniature Phalaenopsis. And I think you can clearly see the difference here. The miniature Phalaenopsis is not as large foliage-wise and bloom-wise. We can see that the flower spikes are thinner, they are not as long, and the flowers are actually a lot tinier. You can understand now why many people actually prefer these types of orchids, because they just fit a little bit better on their desks and they can be a lot more convenient to keep. Even though miniature Phalaenopsis can start to lean over as well, their flowers, being that they are tinier, are typically not as heavy. So a miniature Phalaenopsis is not so prone to just tipping over and fall from the shelf or table. This nature of Phalaenopsis orchids to lean over is a natural instinct, because in their natural habitat, their ancestors would grow something like this attached to the tree trunk. And no matter how much we hybridize these orchids, their normal and natural tendency will always be to lean over. So don't worry about that, but obviously the lighter the orchid is, the less problematic this tendency will be. However, being that they're both Phalaenopsis orchids, just derived from different species, they do share a lot of similarities. Flower shape can be very, very similar, and even though the overall size can differ, the roots, or actually the size of the roots, can be very, very similar. Not only do these orchids have the same tendencies of growing roots, but the thickness of the velamen can actually be very, very similar. So even a miniature Phalaenopsis can outgrow its pot. Due to the fact that they produce smaller blooms, it is not uncommon to see miniature Phalaenopsis producing more than one spike and actually having multiple branches on a spike. Smaller flowers means less energy invested in them, so the flower count can increase, which is another feature that is very appealing on miniature Phalaenopsis. When it comes to colors and patterns, they can actually look pretty similar to their bigger counterparts, or they can have distinct patterns of their own. And apart from small differences in flower shape, they do really resemble a typical Phalaenopsis. So now that we know a little bit about how they compare to normal or standard Phalaenopsis, let's talk about culture tips. For the main part, miniature Phalaenopsis do take almost the exact same care as any other standard Phalaenopsis, with a few adjustments that have to do more with their size than anything else. So as far as light is concerned, they as well don't really enjoy direct hot sun. Just like their standard counterparts, the leaves can overheat and get burned. So choose a place in your home or office which receives bright shade. A little bit of filtered sun in the morning or late afternoon can be absolutely fine, but if possible, from time to time, when you know that the sun is hitting the orchid, touch the leaves and see if they're hot. If they're cold or very, very slightly warm, it's absolutely fine, but if they feel rather hot to the touch, I suggest moving the orchid to a place where it doesn't receive as much sun. Artificial light can work absolutely great for miniature Phalaenopsis, making them perfect for offices which don't really get as much natural light. As a matter of fact, I actually have all of my miniature Phalaenopsis under what we call shop lights, LED panels, which are actually pretty common in offices as well. They are rather close to the orchid, as you can see, because they're not very powerful, but definitely with a desk lamp, you can give your miniature Phalaenopsis adequate amounts of light. When it comes to temperatures, again, these orchids prefer intermediate to warm temperatures like the big Phalaenopsis, which works out great for us because we like the very same thing. So if you're comfortable in the room, most probably these orchids will be as well. A little side note though to keep in mind if you're growing these orchids in an office. Make sure they are not placed in the direct path of an AC or a radiator, because this will change the temperature around them, making it either too cold or too hot. So just be a little bit mindful and place the orchid in a place which is a little bit sheltered from drafts. Humidity levels are not an issue for these orchids either. They are very tolerant to even drier conditions, as long as you maintain them properly hydrated and watered. So again, even if in the environment you are keeping your orchid in, you don't benefit from a lot of humidity, you don't need to place a lot of humidity trays everywhere to increase a little bit that humidity or use humidifiers, because these orchids are just not that sensitive. Obviously, higher humidity will be in the benefit of any orchid, but that will count more when orchids are stressed or they don't have enough roots or you cannot keep up with their watering and they become dehydrated. Other than that, I've never had issues with these orchids, even in very dry conditions. I just had to make sure that I was on top of watering. And speaking about which, watering a miniature Phalaenopsis is done in the exact same way as a normal Phalaenopsis. You can run water through the pot, or you can soak the orchid in a decorative pot or a different container, let it be 5-10 minutes, then drain the orchid pot very well and put it back in its place. A little bit of a difference between these guys and the big Phalaenopsis is the size of the pot. Yes, these orchids do have pretty considerable roots, but they're not produced in such high numbers as the big Phalaenopsis typically. Therefore, you probably will not need as big of a pot. And because the pot is tinier and cannot hold as much medium, it will typically dry faster. So you might find that a typical Phalaenopsis would require watering 5, 7, 10 days, depending on your environment, and your miniature Phalaenopsis will require watering sooner than that. It is perfectly fine and normal. You should water your miniature Phalaenopsis whenever it becomes dry. And the number of days in between waterings will differ from person to person. The roots of miniature Phalaenopsis behave in the same way as standard Phalaenopsis, in the sense that whenever they're dry and they could use a good watering, they will be rather silvery or gray, and when they're wet, they will get this nice green appearance. Mind you, this will only happen if your orchid's roots have access to light. If you grow your orchid in a fully opaque pot, the roots most probably will be white, since the orchid will not allocate chlorophyll pigments to the roots. That is absolutely fine and the roots are perfectly healthy. An orchid doesn't rely on photosynthesis through roots, but through leaves. Reblooming miniature Phalaenopsis is done in the exact same way as standard Phalaenopsis. And I have a video in this series which talks all about that, so I'll link it down below in the description. Basically, miniature Phalaenopsis need to have space to create new flower spikes. They can also create secondary branches, and they will also bloom following a cool down in their environment, which signals the end of summer and the end of vegetative growth. Flowers can last a long time, just like any other Phalaenopsis, and the flower spike can continuously grow for quite a lot of months. As I was saying, it can produce secondary branches, and you can also obtain a keiki from a miniature Phalaenopsis. Everything that applies to normal phals applies to these guys as well. One of the most common questions that I get regarding these orchids is, will they remain as tiny as when we first purchased them? It kind of depends on variety. Most nurseries sell these orchids at their first blooming, so they're pretty young orchids. In time, they can reach a little bit of a bigger size than when we purchased them. How big? Well, nothing like the super big Phalaenopsis on the market, but they can actually reach a sort of medium size. It is not the case with all of them, though, because some, no matter how much they grow and how many years pass, they will remain rather tiny. Most of them will grow just a little bit more in comparison to when we first purchased them, but exactly how much, it really, really depends. There are so many hybrids on the market that it's hard to tell. One thing's for sure, 99.9% of them will never be super, super big as your typical, let's say, white Phalaenopsis. Repotting these orchids follows the same rules as any other Phalaenopsis, and if you want a very, very detailed tutorial, you'll have it linked down below. But basically, it is very helpful to have an aerated pot for these orchids. They are also epiphytes. Transparent pots will help you determine if the medium is dry, if you need to water your orchid, or they can tell you how the roots are doing, particularly useful for beginners. One little side note is that you can actually go for a more water-retentive mix, for example, one that contains a little bit more sphagnum moss, since overall the size of the pot is smaller for miniature Phalaenopsis. You will have to consider the environment you're growing your orchid in as well. I like to use a combination of bark and sphagnum moss for all of my orchids, but of course you can find pre-made mixes on the market as well. And in the video that I linked in the description, you can see the mixes available at RepotMe, which are suited for different types of environment. I would recommend going for the one that has sphagnum moss. And lastly, nutrients are very, very important for these orchids as well, and the better you feed them, the better they will bloom. I recommend starting at half the dosage since they are tiny orchids, but keep in mind, they are Phalaenopsis. They typically do like to eat a lot of food in order to grow well. Deficiencies will not be apparent straight away. They are very, very good at adapting and doing with whatever they have, but lack of nutrients will, in a few years, lead to very small growth, very few flowers, and overall poor flowering and performance. As I was saying, these orchids are actually more prone to creating multiple flowers and branches at the same time. So do make sure you offer food to your miniature Phalaenopsis as well. And that is about it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I hope it will be useful. As a personal note, I actually prefer miniature Phalaenopsis because I can have multiple orchids in the same amount of space that a big Phalaenopsis would take. But of course, they're all beautiful, they're all charming, and it's really up to your preference. And now you know how to care for miniature Phalaenopsis. So with that said, I hope you have a great day and thank you again for watching. Thank you RepotMe for sponsoring this video and making this whole entire series possible. Subscribe to my channel for more orchid videos, tutorials, experiments, updates, and other fun orchid subjects. If you wish to support the channel, do consider becoming a member or visit the merch store linked down below in the description. You can also follow me on Instagram and Facebook. It's always nice to stay in touch there as well. And with that said, I'll see you guys next time. Bye!